Rove is branching out from making us grown-ups laugh. Now he's cracking up the kids too.
I just been to a shop and I just bought this. It's my new book. It's called The Book That Grown-Ups Get Wrong, written and illustrated, which means I wrote it and I drew it as well. Please go get my book. Go and buy my book.
Did you get the message? Would you please welcome Rove?
Well, thank you very much.
For all the years on television.
That's all there is to say. It's exactly that.
The press release says national entertainment icon.
Do you know what I love, Hamish, is how much you have distanced yourself from that phrase. Even in the intro, that very clearly read as, this is someone else's words, not mine. I don't know how to take that.
But you stipulate this stuff, obviously. Like, you would
have approval. It feels like it's in quotation marks. Would that be fair to say?
Well, it is in the script.
Yeah, I'll accept that. I feel very iconic. Don't you reckon?
You are, yeah. Yeah.
Wow, that's so dismissive.
The book is wonderful. It's beautiful. It's called The Book That Grown-Ups Get Wrong.
Yes.
The premise being?
That it is impossible for any adult, any grown-up, to read this book to a child and get it right. It's just, it's impossible.
Why? Because it's sort of this,
it's intentionally written so that the very simple idea of here is a frog, and when you're reading it, the book forces you to call everything in the book by something different, and it builds in its ridiculousness as it goes along. It all came about. I was at a kids party. I have a child, so it was all above board.
It was legit.
It was all there. I wasn't gate crashing because that would just be awkward
and illegal in most parts.
I just walked in and said, "I'm an entertainment icon," and they said, "Come on in, sir, please." And there was one of the performers. There's like a kids entertainer who had been hired for the day, and they were pretending they didn't know what hide and seek was. So they said, "Everyone, let's play hide and sleep," and the kids are all, "No, that's not what it's called." "Oh, that's right, it's hide and sweep." "No." And the kids thought it was hilarious.
Yeah.
And I thought, yeah, there's something in the empowerment of kids feeling like they know more than the grown-ups do.
And it's a bit fun to gaslight your kids as well at that time, isn't it? That's right. I reckon.
That's exactly right.
For all those early starts. Hey, your daughter Ruby, yes. She's 9 now.
She is.
Do you still do bedtime stories with her?
Yeah, we do. We read every night. She's a voracious reader. She's doing a little bit more of her own reading, so we sort of find that we're not doing as much together. We did read the entire Harry Potter series a chapter a night, and it took us just over a year to do it, to get through all the books together.
Wow.
That was great fun.
Her reading it or you?
So I was doing most of the reading and then we took parts doing the voices.
Yeah, because I feel like you would really
be so
a
good
voices man in the nighttime reading.
You've got to try to spice it up and
keep interested. You know a thing or two about showbiz.
Well, then
you're a world-renowned entertainment icon.
The big question becomes, which Dumbledore do you do? Do you do Richard Harris? Or Michael Gambon.
So which?
Well, I go OG Richard Harris.
Go on, give it to us.
It's all very much.
Come on.
50 points to Hufflepuff.
It gets a bit scratchy though.
I want to know if Ruby gave you feedback on your book.
She did. She'd been waiting for this one to come out because she has also contributed to the book. So at the start, there's an illustration of a frog, and as it's narrated through the book, what's this? Oh, that's right. It's a hot dog riding a skateboard. It's the first one. So you're off to the races early with just a stupid premise. So then I had to keep up in the ante, and I just started to sort of freak out about what would be entertaining to a kid. So I turned to my then 8-year-old daughter and said, "What do you think's the weirdest thing you can think of?" And she went, "A unicorn with a horn made entirely out of eyebrows." So that's in there.
Oh, fantastic.
As is also a shout out to my comedian friend Dave Callan, who is a certified ninja.
Oh.
So there is a reference to Dave the Ninja in the book. So really, I haven't done any of this myself.
Has Ruby negotiated royalties? I want to know.
No.
What's on the back
but,
end?
If we sell enough, she'll go through school. So please buy a book from this entertainment icon and apparent plagiarist.
For more info on how you can get the book that grown-ups get wrong, head to our links page. Would you please thank the wonderful Rove?
Thank you very much.